own zone. At the point, Fisher shot, and they score! Kluche gets a piece, but Fisher with the shot that may have been tipped. That is exactly what Vancouver Canucks didn't need, and Kluche included. Chelios gets it deep. Yzerman behind the net. Works against Sokol. Spun out by Shanahan. Chelios shot, scores! A power play goal! Chris Chelios, another point shot that gets by Kluche. And this one goes straight in. Straight in for Chris Chelios. Chris, I'm a little surprised that Vancouver have not picked on Yzerman yet and nailed him a couple times to test his knee. Letowski, a bad angle shot. Letowski's got it again in front. The goal! Matthias Holland!
Just a look at it because, first of all, it's a good shoot into the zone. And here comes Letowski. He's just going to chase down to the fence and challenge. And at the top left of your screen, you're going to see Datsyuk lose his man. It's Matthias Holland right there who comes in late. And Letowski with a perfect pass as he hoops the puck around Chelios' foot and finds Matthias Holland. And Datsyuk just let him go.
Bertuzzi knocked down in front by Dandino.
Here comes the shot. Look at the puck. Just somehow hits the post and stays out.
Yeah, off Hasek and off the post.
Watch Bertuzzi here, though. He gives there Hasek a shot to the left pad. Now that is goalie interference, and that time he got away with it.
Faceoff won by Vancouver. Olin tees it up and fires off hook wide of the net.
Brendan Shanahan does all the work there with a strong forecheck, and he'll just throw it towards Yzerman there. After Kluche gets his stick into the play, but he cheats way too early.
And it's tipped past Sokol, down the ice, a race for it, and Kluche out, but knocking away from Dandino, who got a piece of Kluche, and Kluche shaken up. And who's it going to be? It will be Dandino, Barron tackling the Red Wing player after the collision with the goaltender.
And Kluche at the moment, I am sure, does not know where he is. He got his bell rung, his mask is off, and he's down.
The clearance kept in by Castles, the man off the bench. O'Mahony gets it down. Draper, open net, scores! And he crashes into the net after the insurance goal in the final minute. And back down ice for a moment. It looked like Bertuzzi and Chelios were going to go. And that's why everybody sprinted to center. Thursday night, they'll break the tie as the Red Wings have fought back to win two straight in Vancouver.
For the first time in this series, the Canucks outplayed, outhit, and outchanced the Red Wings. But as Vancouver showed in games 1 and 2, that does not always decide who wins.
It's frustrating, but that's the situation. And we just had, you know, we stayed persistent and we got back and we got even. And, you know, the game was there for us.
It was a tough one tonight because I thought we came out and played well and worked hard, worked through a lot of breaks, but just couldn't get the win.
You have to come out and play hard, and it changes from period to period, goal to goal. So, you know, we feel good going home, but the first period, we can't allow them to come out and dominate the period. We have to come out and play strong right off the hops.
Unlike Game 3, the Canucks came out flying in the first period, but two goals on the Wings' first three shots forced Vancouver to play catch-up for most of the night. The Wings' first three goals came after giveaways by Canuck defensemen trying to clear the zone.
It's tough, you know, just because we battled so hard to, you know, get where we were going into the third period. And, you know, but, you know, those, you know, freak breaks happen that, you know, kind of kill the momentum.
Doesn't matter who makes the mistakes or how they look, but it's definitely, you know, when you make mistakes against a team like Detroit, you know, they're going to capitalize on the scoring chances.
This series has also been a tale of two captains. The Canucks' Marcus Naslund looked ineffective in Game 4 and has just 1 point in this series. Stevie Yzerman, meanwhile, picked up another 2 points in this game. He has 7 on the series and moved past Gordie Howe into first place on the Red Wings' all-time playoff points list with 159. Farhan Lalji, TSN, Vancouver.